Welcome to the Homeschool with Moxie podcast, where our goal is to inspire and encourage you with actionable strategies to take you from overwhelmed to confident in your homeschool adventure. I'm your host, Abby Banks, and this is episode number 79. This episode is brought to you by my Etsy Quick Start Guide. If you've ever wanted to start an Etsy shop and you thought, boy, this just feels overwhelming, I'm not sure how to get it done and get it done quickly, then I want you to check out my ebook, the Etsy Quick Start Guide. This thing is what I wrote because I had so many friends and family asking, how do I start an Etsy shop? How did you do it? So I sat down, I got tons of screenshots in there, tons of easy to follow step-by-step instructions that will get you up and running and successfully selling on Etsy really quickly. So I want you to check out the show notes. I'll have a coupon code for you there. And if you actually want to download a free Etsy Quick Start checklist that'll get you started for free and even faster, you can find that in the show notes too at 41more.com/79. So if you're looking to find more money in your budget this year, there are two ways you can do it, right? You can make money, which is why I brought up the Etsy Quick Start Guide. It's a great way to have a side gig as a homeschool mom if you're crafty or if you design printables or home decor or things like that. It's a great way to bring in a little extra cash. But what's the other way to make those dollars stretch? What's another way to make your budget work? You can bring in money or you can save money. And so when I heard from Rhonda Collins, the founder of Toycycle.co, I knew I needed to bring her on the podcast to explain to you how you can shop an online thrift shop that's not what you think of when you sometimes think of shopping on eBay, where things are might be a little dingy, you're not sure if they're clean, you're not sure if they're even all the pieces are all there. No, if you check out Toycycle.co, you are going to find a brilliantly clean, organized, easy-to-use website where you can find amazing deals for your babies, your toddlers, your young children. They have toys, gear, clothing. I'm so excited about this because I'm a lifelong thrifter. I have always adored finding deals at yard sales, thrift stores. And honestly, when we were raising our children and they were young, we bought stuff secondhand all the time, even for Christmas gifts. They didn't know that their big pile of plastic dinosaur toys came from the thrift store. They didn't care, but we were super happy to not pay full retail price for them, right? So honestly, you don't need to shop new. And this is a super great way for you homeschooling families who might be homeschooling on one income because maybe mom is staying home to homeschool the kids, or maybe dad's staying home to homeschool the kids, and you might be sacrificing a little bit of income. Well, if you're looking to make your budget stretch, then I think Toycycle.co is a great website to check out when you need to buy, you know, birthday gifts, Christmas gifts, or you just need gear, right? You need the diaper bag, or you need the whatever you're looking for. You don't want to buy it new. Check out Toycycle. And the super fun thing is that Rhonda is giving my listeners a coupon code, which you can find in the show notes at 41more.com/79. And this coupon code is only good until the end of September 2020. So it's only about 2 weeks. So if you're listening to this episode when it goes live, you have about 2 weeks to use it. And it's going to give you a whopping 25% off your purchase. So if you figure out you're already saving a ton of off of normal retail price, then you add that other 25% off your purchase. If you use my coupon code, you're going to be getting some really good deals. So check out the code and the link for Rhonda's site in the show notes at 41more.com/79. So here's my conversation with Rhonda Collins, the founder of Toycycle.co. Rhonda, thanks for joining me on today's episode.
Thank you for having me, Abby.
This is a super fun topic. I am a lifelong thrifter. So when you contacted me and told me about your website, I knew that other homeschool moms were going to probably feel similarly excited about it. We're all about saving money, efficiency, right? We don't want to drag everyone to the store with us to go shopping. Mm-hmm. So I love the idea behind Toycycle.co. And if we could just start out, tell us about your website and why did you start it?
Well, I also am a lifelong thrifter. I learned recycling and being conservative with resources from my mother many years ago. And Then I had twin daughters. They're about to turn 11, actually. Prior to having kids, other moms may have this experience, I lived a fairly minimal lifestyle, and it was quite easy to make the choices that I needed to make that were sustainable choices that felt good to me. And then I had kids, and it's a whole different thing. There's so much that you need, so much gear, you need toys, you know, all the clothing. And it became really clear to me quickly that this was a challenge and that there were no good resources or choices for helping me with this challenge. And so at a certain point, obviously it took me a little while, my kids are almost 11, but at a certain point when they were around six or so, I was thinking, I'm going to do something, and thought about it for a little while and then embarked upon it. We did have a first product, which was a peer-to-peer swap platform. And what we found there was that while there was a group of moms that were able to engage in that platform and just share with one another locally, most of the moms who were signing up didn't engage. And when we asked them why, they said they didn't have time. Their intent was there, but they just couldn't get around to it. So that's when we decided to go with this full service program where we're going to help moms by doing it for them.
Totally makes sense. And I love that you can be anywhere and shop this online thrift store, right? So why should moms consider buying from your site then, instead of just going and buying new from the store? What are the benefits that they're going to have from buying it used? It is used, although you have some new stuff. I've looked through your site. You do have some new stuff. But why should we buy from your site rather than always just going and buying the latest new thing?
Right. Well, first of all, there's the cost savings. Mm-hmm. You save anywhere from, 20 to 80% buying used, whether from our store or any consignment shop or anywhere that you buy used. So that's a good choice in terms of the pocketbook. But what really is good about it is that it is so beneficial to the environment. When you purchase used instead of new, there's less demand for those new products. New products require, resources. They require there's climate change aspects to that, carbon, emissions and so forth, use of water and other scarce resources to produce those goods. So when you buy used, you're avoiding that impact on the environment. And also, obviously, anything that could end up in the waste stream that is diverted and continues in use, prevents that aspect of harm to the environment. So it's just a great choice all the way around. It's a win-win for everyone. And as far as our site in particular, one of the things that I really wanted to do, because I was frustrated myself, there are a lot of options out there for buying things used. You can go to, eBay or Craigslist or Facebook or OfferUp. There's a million marketplaces. There's no quality control. So everyone I've talked to, and I personally have had these experiences where something showed up, which was not what I expected. It was dirty or it was broken or it just wasn't in the condition that I had anticipated. And so I was really disappointed. Mm-hmm. What we do is we vet every single product. And if you buy something from Toycycle, it's in great condition. It's exactly as described. It's cleaned, it's inspected, and we back it up with a customer satisfaction guarantee. If it doesn't work for you, you send it back to us and we refund your money.
So there's literally no risk, sounds like.
That's right.
Yeah, we can try it and we can be pretty, there's no scam going on. If it's not what we think it is, which it will be, because you've inspected it. So I love that. There's an extra set of eyes on this, making sure that it's what you say the product is. That's really important, isn't it? Especially with germs right now and not wanting to get stuff from who knows where. Pretty important. Yep. So what kind of products do you have for sale? Can you give us some examples? What are your categories? What can we find on Toycycle?
Now on Toycycle, you can find just about anything. The only thing that we don't carry at the moment are car seats, and there are liability issues around car seats, so that's why we avoid those. But we've got all sorts of gear. Big gear and small gear. Just to be clear, we're headquartered in the San Francisco Bay Area, And because we are, one, environmentally conscious, and two, there are cost considerations when shipping large items, mm-hmm. we only deliver our large items in the broader San Francisco Bay Area. So if you're in New York, you can't buy a stroller from us and expect us to ship it. Mm-hmm. But everything else does ship if it's smaller and shippable. We've got toys, lots of toys. We've got clothing, and we've got all of these other smaller gear items, diaper bags, breast pumps, baby carriers, swaddles, anything that you can imagine that you might need. We've got them. And just to clarify what you were mentioning earlier, almost everything on our site is used. Even if it's new with tags, it's come from another family. Mm-hmm. They just had so much stuff they didn't use that particular item, so they're still new, they're unused. Mm-hmm. We do carry a couple of brands, Plan Toys and Begin Again Toys, who we have vetted as having sustainable practices throughout their supply chain. So we feel really great about those companies and feel like buying new from them is a great investment. And so we do carry some of those products as well.
Very interesting. And I love this because babies, toddlers, they don't care if something's new. They just care that it's new to them. So there is so much savings to be had by realizing our kids don't need everything brand new. They don't even know difference. So excellent thoughts there. So how do you figure out then the price that you're going to sell these toys and this gear for? How do you price them? What kind of savings are people going to see?
Yeah, we have a formula for pricing based on the condition of items, and everything in our store is conditioned either good, excellent, like new, or new. So there's nothing that's fair or, you know, has any issues of that sort. We typically are following standard guidelines for pricing used products. So they're going to be in the range of what you might find them in a consignment shop somewhere. If it's a new product, we might price it at 65% of what you would find it in retail, let's say on Amazon or somewhere. If it's just a product that's in excellent condition, we're going to price it at around 40 or 45% of retail. And if it's in good condition, and on our site, that means it's in great condition, but maybe it's missing one little part that doesn't affect the functionality, we might price that at 30%. So your cost savings can be anywhere from 30 to 70% off of retail.
Wow. And I think I saw something on your site where if it sits there for a month, do you start reducing the price as well?
We typically do start reducing the price, yes, after a certain period of time. And that it can vary based on the product and so forth. So yes, around a month, and then 2 months again, there will be another reduction.
So this is fun for those treasure hunter moms who normally would go to a thrift store and look for the deals or, you know, clearance items. Like they can find even these reductions on your site, which is super fun. Feels like you're getting a really good deal, which you are. So who can participate in your consignment program then? Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah. Right now, only families in the San Francisco Bay Area can actually consign with us. We do take curbside pickup, so we offer a super convenient service for the families that consign with us. And we also take some clean out boxes, but those as well have to be in the larger sort of Northern California area. And the reason for that is the cost of shipping is really prohibitive. We do intend to grow. And as we grow, we will bring on other sellers in other areas. And then they will be able to provide those consignment services for families who would like to consign with us. And of course, we will continue to just make these offerings available to the entire country.
Sounds so fun. So I love this idea. I'm going to link to your site in my show notes and my listeners can go check it out. But as we wrap up, is there anything that I missed that you would love my listeners to know?
I would just love them to give us a try. As you said previously, and as I can say, it's risk-free. We would love to offer you the opportunity to try us out. You'll see what great products we have on offer to you, and then become a customer, regular, and share it with all your friends.
Awesome. Rhonda, thanks so much for jumping in on this little chat with me. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Abby.
I hope you enjoyed listening in on this chat with Rhonda, and jump into the show notes. You'll get a coupon code and you can find more information about Toycycle if you go to 411more.com/79. And in the meantime, happy homeschooling.